When I was growing up in the early 1960s, I spent a lot of time in the vast wasteland of network television. At that time, we were able to receive a grand total of 3 television stations representing the 3 major commercial networks. Now that most of us can receive over 50 channels with the advent of cable television, from my perspective, the wasteland has only grown vaster. However, there was one network television program during that period that seemed to be a cut above the rest. This was a program centered on 2 free-thinking young men who traveled about the United States in a Corvette as they kept getting into little adventures, and for the most part, not getting into trouble. The program was called Route 66 and ran weekly on CBS from 1960 until 1964. At that time, since I was only a teenager, it seemed like a good idea to be able to drive around the US of A in a new Corvette and get odd jobs without worrying about how it looked on one's resume. The creator and writer of the series, the late Sterling Siliphant, was the brain behind the scenes, keeping the action going week to week. Filmed on location from Portland, Oregon in the west to Niagara Falls in the east, the program had some interesting plots and dialogue for its time. Now in syndication, the dialogue in the show does fall short and the plots seem a bit corny. But think about it, 2 young men who are not attracted to each other driving around the country in a sports car, not worried about their careers, their IRAs, their Roth plans, their 401k plans, or the price of gasoline. Martin Milner played the erudite Todd Stiles, and in the first couple of seasons, George Maharis played the Hell's Kitchen-esque, New York City-accented Buzz Murdoch. I am not certain if I identified more with Stiles or Murdoch, but I certainly identified with that Corvette. And I am certain that General Motors sold a lot of Corvettes because of this program. In a radio interview with Maharis, I learned that Chevrolet did not allow neither Milner nor Maharis to use the sports car after shooting hours. Perhaps they were afraid the boys would get into some real life adventures. The program went off the air for a lot of reasons, the foremost being that the shooting crew was just tired. They filmed for months at a time, 7 days a week. While the program was based on the real Route 66, which runs from Chicago to Los Angeles, very few episodes were actually filmed on the famed highway. Buzz Maharis had developed hepatitis and was replaced by a more stoic Glenn Corbett. And the reality of an assassinated president, as well as an unpopular war in Southeast Asia, also played a part in the show's demise. And finally, there was the end of Route 66, the highway itself. The outdated and poorly maintained vestiges of the U.S. Highway 66 succumbed to the interstate highway system that paralleled the original route. I-40 was about to change the entire aspect of the meandering original highway through America's midsection. The final interstate section of I-40 was completed at Williams, Arizona in October of 1984. Looking back on the way America has changed since the early 1960s, I guess it was only appropriate that Martin Milner should go from an existentialist, peripatetic sports car driver to playing the part of a cop as Officer Pete Malloy on Adam 12. I think the country would be a much better place if we had more people seeing the country from behind the wheel of a 1962 Corvette than behind the wheel of a black and white police cruiser.